Hello all, this is the second lecture on material synthesis processing and application. So in this lecture we are going to see diffusion. So first of all we will try to understand what we mean by diffusion. So diffusion can be defined as mass flow process. So in order to understand the diffusion we will take a small example. Let's say we have a glass of water. And if we put salt inside the glass of water, that salt will spread out inside the water. So this spreading of this salt inside the water is nothing but diffusion. So here solid is diffused inside the liquid. Sometimes it may happen like gas, let's say we have scent. That scent will diffuse inside the room, and we can say the liquid or gas is diffused in the gas. So here we will consider solid diffused in the solid at the by the use of concentration gradient and by using the heat treatment. So basically whenever we study diffusion, at that time we have to consider the concentration gradient and the temperature at which we are going to diffuse that substance. So for that purpose Fick has given two important laws. One of these is Fick's first law and second law. So first we will study, in this case we will study Fick's first law of diffusion. So what does this law tell us? Whenever there is unidirectional flow of atoms, that unidirectional means, let's say we have two different types of atoms. Let's say atom A and atom B. So whenever there is a flow of atom type of B type of atom from B side to A side, so the direction of the flow of the beam is in one direction, that is unidirectional flow, and we will not consider the flow of atom A in B. So only we have considered flow of atom B in A. So this law mathematically tells us dN upon dt is equal to minus dA dc upon dx, where this dN upon dt is the number of moles of B atoms crossing per unit time a cross-sectional area of plane A perpendicular to the diffusion direction x. So whenever we have B type of atom crossing the A type of material A type of atoms through the cross-sectional area A, so at that time we have to see what is the total number of moles of atoms that are passed from B side to A side. So at that time we have to consider this relation. So d is nothing but diffusivity or diffusion coefficient, and dc upon dx is the concentration gradient. And negative sign here, this negative sign indicates that the matter that flows from the higher concentration to the lower concentration, and the flux, that is J, which is defined by modifying, means rearranging the Fick's first law, and which is defined as 1 upon A dN upon dt. That means J is the flux, that is the amount of substance flowing from one place to another place per unit cross-sectional area per unit time. And this Fick's first law of diffusion is true only if the flow is steady state, the condition is steady state condition. So we will see what is the steady state condition. Okay, for that purpose we will consider concentration distance profile for steady state flow. So whenever d is, you can say d is the diffusion, and if it is a function of concentration, so in that case the relationship is straight line. And whenever d is a can say is a function of concentration, so it is it shows a nonlinear behavior with respect to concentration, you can say distance. So whenever we have steady state, at that time d is not a function of concentration, and whenever d is a function of concentration, at that time there is no steady state. So by using these things we will solve one problem, and this is one of the interesting problem in the physics. So a steel can contains a hydrogen atom at a constant pressure of 10 atmosphere with a vacuum outside. So there is vacuum outside. The hydrogen concentration at the inner surface of the tank is 10 kg per meter cube. The diffusion coefficient of the hydrogen in steam at room temperature is 10 to minus 9 meters per second. and calculate the rate at which hydrogen escapes through the walls of the steam tank, which has a thickness of 5 mm. So first of all, whenever the problem is given, we have to figure out what is given. So here, see, the constant pressure of the hydrogen atom that is given, and there is vacuum outside the steel tank. The hydrogen concentration at the inner surface of the tank is equal to 10 kg per meter cube, and outside the tank, the concentration is 0. So concentration difference is 10 kg per meter square. The diffusion coefficient for the hydrogen atom in the steam at room temperature is 10⁻⁹ meters square per second, that is D is given, and we have to calculate G. And the X is also given through which the diffusion is occurring. So X is 5 mm. So we have this formula, J is equal to minus D, dc upon dx. D is given, dc, that is difference in concentration, that is also given, and dx, that means the length of the diffusion, the length traveled by the diffusion atom, that is also given. So if we use that formula, we get J is equal to D, that is 10⁻⁹, into dc, that is difference in the concentration gradient, that is 10 kg per meter cube, and that dx, that is 5 mm, which is nothing but 5 into 10⁻³. So finally we get 2 into 10⁻⁶ kg per meter square per second. That means 2 mg of hydrogen escapes per second per unit area. So even though it is closed from all the sides, the hydrogen can escape from the steam tank, and it is not a small amount. So that's why we need to study such diffusion law in detail. So thank you for watching this video.